Moe's widow, herself once a great performer known professionally as Sadie Gale, recalls her wedding day.
We were married after the show at 11:30 at night, and the people in the company didn't know till the next day. The friends of my grandparents in Arncliffe, I was born in Arncliffe, you know, and I believe one of them said to one of my aunties, "Oh, fancy Sadie marrying that dirty old Mo."
What made Roy Rene Mo such a great comedian? It wasn't only his impeccable timing, his technique and his vocal inflections. It was his human appeal, because, as he would say himself, he was one of the mob. And because he was one of the mob loved him.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, my friend, what does it feel like to be a hero?
I have mixed feelings.
Mixed feelings?
Well, yes. When I came ashore, two old gentlemen shook my hand, and two young gentlemen shook my what?
Tonight, I am going to present you with a gold medal for bravery. But before that, I'd like to tell our audience all about your heroism.
Yes, do that now. Stick around and look modest.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, hey, tell them what a fine fellow I am.
Go on. All right. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen.
I lay it on a bit because I've got a lot of friends listening.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen.
Very influential friends, too. Like doctors and lawyers and bookmakers and urgers.
Will you shut up?
Oh, that's lovely, that is. Fancy saying shut up to a fella who spent a half hour swimming around the harbour like a raw prawn.
All right, I'm sorry.
And so you should be.
I apologise.
I accept it.
Now I'll proceed.
Yeah, but lay it on thick, don't forget, will you? Lay it on thick.
Ladies and gentlemen, the facts of the case are these. This amazing feat of heroism took place last Saturday evening at exactly 7:25.
Now, you'll pardon me, 7:26. Oh.
It was on a manly ferry.
The Kirkur.
I know that!
Yeah, but the mob don't.
All right. You were on the Curl, all right. Travelling from Manly to Circular Quay.
By water.
Of course you were travelling by water. I know you were travelling by water.
Well, tell them that. You're leaving out all the best parts.
I'm sorry.
Well, right. Well, take the seat.
As I was saying, the ferry Curl left Manly for Circular Quay, and on board her was our friend Mo.
Oh, no, I wasn't.
Oh, but you were.
Oh, no, I wasn't.
What do you mean?
I just remembered I was on the Berengaria.
Oh. All right, it was the Baron Joey.
Well, there's no need to do your block.
I'm not doing my block.
Well, I'm sorry.
So you should be.
I apologize.
Well, I accept it. Pray proceed.
As I was saying, our hero was traveling over from Manly by ferry.
Hey, I'm supposed to be telling a story, not you.
Well, get on with it. I can't stand here all night looking modest.
Ladies and gentlemen, our hero was travelling over from Manly by the ferry Baron Joey. Now, is that right?
No, but a small correction.
Well?
I just remembered. It was the Curl after all.
Look, excuse me, but let us get this straight.
Don't be silly. You can't get a Curl straight.
One minute you say it's one ferry, the next minute you say it's another. What did it have written on the side?
Some very rude poetry.
Oh, really? Well, I never saw that.
No, I just wrote it on the way over.
Ladies and gentlemen, our hero was travelling over by ferry. The name of the ferry is immaterial.
No, my name is Kirker.
Shut up, will you?
I have.
Our hero was travelling on this ferry, and on the deck below, there happened to be a very pretty young lady.
There happened to be six or seven.
Well, that may be, but we're only interested in one.
You speak for yourself.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ferry is speeding on its way through the waters. All around, darkness is gathering, when suddenly...
Bump!
What was that?
We just bumped a jellyfish.
Well, that doesn't matter.
It did to the jellyfish.
On and on sped the ferry. Suddenly, the air was rent by a piercing shriek. The young lady had fallen overboard.
Peppers! A lovely abdominal crack.
Yes, into the shark-infested harbor fell the young girl. Everybody rushed to the rail, and there in the sea below struggled the young girl. Suddenly a figure was seen to flash from the upper deck into the sea below. My friend, you all know the rest of the story. You've heard it on the radio and you've read it in newspapers. And now it only remains for me to present our hero with this solid gold medal and to acclaim him the bravest man I know.
Thank you.
Well, surely, my friend, you have something to say.
No, just thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, like all heroes, our friend is modest. But tell us, Mo, what was flashing through your mind as you hurtled into that shark-infested sea?
I kept thinking, who could it be? Who could it be?
Ah, you mean the girl you were about to rescue?
No, the dirty mug who pushed me overboard.